collect the $1 sharing offering to help others. So there's an insert and envelopes in the pews for that. And then if you wanted to take one of those banks to put your coins in home, they're on the table at the back entrance as well. Our movie night's the 21st, A Matter of Faith. This is March, so it's also the month that your donations to the food pantry go a little further, right?
Yes.
Okay. Next week, you change your clocks ahead. So you move ahead, or you'll be late.
Or you'll be early.
Yeah, you can come to Sunday school if you come early.
Be early, yeah.
Anyway, yeah, that's how it is. I got a nice letter from Carolyn Gilbert. She is really enjoying getting the newsletter that we have and like the church history that Polly works on. And Kathy, Carol Peel, and Carolyn Stevens were talked about, and Joanne helped with some of those. Of course, she likes the Pastor's Corner, which is nice. She likes the poems that Tom Arrow does and the different things and all the different news and stuff, and she just looks forward to the time when she can be here in the summer, hopefully not having to stay away because of things like last year. And then Linda's Corner, so she likes all those things and makes her think about the church and remember everybody here. Is there any other announcements anybody else has today? Okay, yeah, that should be good. So let's look to your bulletin and we'll join with the call to worship responsibly. Lent is a coming home.
Home from weary years.
Home to calm our fears.
Home to dry our tears.
Lent is a coming home.
Home to remember our name.
Home to a warm embrace.
Home to a hopeful place.
Home to God's own heart.
Home to renewal of joy.
Our first music selection is titled Pious Jesus by Sister Kirjepo. That's how you pronounce it, but we've heard her before.
Peace, O Lord.
bulletin, then we'll join in our prayer of confession for today. Let us pray together.
Guide our feet, holy God, on your path, for we are tempted to stray. We turn toward the chief success, the fleeting fame, the passing fad. We are always looking to someone or some purchase or some experience to fill our souls. But nothing lasts except the constant pull of your love. Holy God, tune our hearts to your commands. Fill our minds with your counsels. Keep our eyes on Jesus, our companion and guide. Amen.
Jesus gave the most extravagant gift of all, the offering of himself for us. Through this selfish gift, we are set free and our sins are forgiven.
Thanks be to God.
As Sue's getting ready, we just know that all of us have gone through our trials and tribulations and our storms. And in all of this, we need to remember to be quiet and to remember that God is there for us. So the name of our song is Peace Be Still. Says peace, peace, be still. Lifts his hands, peace, be still. Like a child, my heart obeys him when he says.
His hand. Thanks, Sue and Kathy, for Peace Be Still. That was beautiful. Let's pray. Gracious God, we do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from your mouth. Make us hungry for this heavenly food, that it may nourish us today in the ways of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, the bread of heaven. Amen. I'm going to start with verse 16 because it's through the Holy Spirit in our lives working that we know that we are children of God. So 16 through 28. It is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. If in fact we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory about to be revealed to us. For the creation waits with eager longing for the revealing of the children of God. For the creation was subjected to futility, not of its own will, but by the will of the one who subjected it. In hope that the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to decay and will obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope, for who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words, and God who searches the heart knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. We know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. God's holy word.
Everything happens for a reason. It seems biblical, right? But it's not. Do you know why it's not true? And do you know what God actually teaches about his purposes and promises in our lives? Over the past couple of weeks, we've been talking about stupid things that even Christians believe. Of course, these things that people believe don't seem stupid. At least to them at the time. In fact, many of these things people believe seem perfectly reasonable, almost biblical.